has created machines, an alien form.
The B-side word.
Alexander, you bought this article, didn't you?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
I'm so All excited.
Right. I'm excited for this one as well.
Should we have an intro to it?
Like
I'm
what?
So excited.
Yes, play the intro.
What's the music for that?
I'm so excited.
Let's play it.
Wow, the video is way different to what
I like this video.
This video is so different to what I imagined.
Very sexual.
Oh, wait, is the song about that?
Can we just get to the chorus?
It is! Oh my
okay.
God!
I never realized! Tonight, we're gonna make it happen.
She's in the bubble bath and she's getting ready. She's in her satin short nightie.
All this time!
How is this song used, like, on mainstream TV in the middle of the day for, like, anything? I've never connected those dots.
I wrap my legs around you. I won't stop thinking enough.
CJ.
Didn't they use this for like a chocolate ad?
Yeah. Did they? Maltesers.
I think so. Was
it? It was called masturbation.
CJ. All right.
All right, I'm excited.
So we're very excited about this article.
This article is exciting.
So
guys,
I'm tired
guys.
Now.
No, Siege. This is gonna wake you up.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
We've lived in a world for the past 12,000 years in the modern human era where we've speculated.
I'm old, but I'm not that old.
Yeah.
We've speculated many things, and we look back in time for evidence of crazy things that have happened that we're still not yet aware of. And even to this day, we hear these stories from recent times of people looking up into the skies and wondering what else is out there. And we see these things flying above. And for years, we've known them as these unidentified flying objects.
UFO. Yes.
These things that we're just... We can't quite put a finger on it, but... There's always the possibility.
CJ's like,
there's always the possibility that it could just be something human made.
Right.
But when the Pentagon confirms that they have a craft, a vehicle that is not of this world.
Yeah.
We are entering new territory.
We are entering new territory.
Guys, evidence,
yes.
Real world, classified, unclassified now.
Yep.
Evidence. With the Pentagon.
Where is it?
So the Pentagon, I've not read the article at all.
So I've got a little bit. So an astrophysicist who consulted on the UFO program confirms that the government possesses materials from off-world vehicles not made on this earth.
wait, off-world, not on this earth.
There you go, double.
Yeah. Double.
So my question is this. Did they have to do a special test where they had to say person, woman, man, camera, TV?
Who, the aliens?
Because if they did, I'm not believing them.
No, it wasn't that person. So a Pentagon spokesperson, this article is from Popular Mechanics. So a Pentagon spokesperson told Popular Mechanics that... while a government aerial phenomena for that, sorry, while a government program did investigate unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, and other unexplained aerial phenomena for some time last decade, that funding had dried up in 2012. However, Popular Mechanics thoroughly investigated this and this covert program. And apparently not, it didn't dry up. It's still continuing to this day, which has been also confirmed by the New York Post and their sources. Now, Harry Reid, who was a former Nevada senator, who was also instrumental in funding the original UFO program, has said that crashes from other worlds have occurred and that they've retrieved materials and been studying these materials for decades, often by aerospace companies under government contracts. This is already insane.
Now Emma... Okay,
the X-Files explained this already. The X-Files explained that the human race has created machines, an alien form, to confuse people.
Are you sourcing a TV program?
X-Files. Scully and... Who is it? Scully and who?
Mulder and Scully have already figured this out. All right? I don't want to name drop, but I am.
I've never watched X-Files. Yeah. But Mulder and Scully is a weird set of names. Like, how did they come up with
that? They got a weird job. So if you got a weird job, you have a weird name.
Yeah, right.
If you just said to me...
I thought you knew about that.
If you said to me, like, Mulder and Scully, I'm like, is that like an activity we're doing later? Or
I thought it was a cleaning product.
No, I didn't even really watch the X-Files and I know their name.
Mulder's the sprayer and then Scully's the guy, the thing that you use to wipe the actual tiles.
All right. Like this has been worked out. The government is using the machines to keep, like, you know, spread out diseases and stuff that are going to kill the human race, yeah, to bring down the numbers.
Right.
Okay?
Thanos style.
It's already been sorted.
Right.
Mulder and Scully are on this. So,
right. And this is what this is what I was saying to Dev a bit earlier. Like, I've always believed in UFOs, whatever. We've talked about this in the past, but it's just incredible to me how for all these years they have been denying, killing people, discrediting people in high positions, or that have worked in NASA, or just people in general that are skeptical about their lies, saying it's complete BS, and now it's finally going to come out. So I don't think they have... So I think, Alexander, they haven't as yet 100% confirmed it, but they are going to be doing so shortly is what is being speculated. Because I
headlines
think that
got me again.
I think that they've been given a deadline to release information.
Welcome to my world.
Yeah.
What, Emma? Who is our friend? Who is our friend that has given massive details?
Bob Lazar.
Now, are you guys familiar with Lazar? Good old
sort
Bob.
Of. Sorry. Sort
if
of.
If you listen to just one of his podcasts, if you listen to his podcast, his latest podcast with Joe Rogan, he goes into detail about these materials and such and the whole project because he was brought into it. So when you listen to him talk about it, it's really fascinating.
You can even watch the Netflix doco. Because most people have Netflix as well. Bob Lazar, Area 51 and Flying Saucers. But yeah, the government completely try and shut him down, don't they?
Yeah, massively. Massively.
They discredit his whole past.
I love a conspiracy theory.
Yeah, they say that he never went to uni, he never worked at NASA. Meanwhile, there's like bits of evidence popping up from other places, like news clippings with him outside the, you know, saying Bob Lazar from whatever has built this and whatever, but they're completely denying him, discrediting him.
If he truly knows something, they wouldn't be discrediting him. They've just sort of shot him by now.
So you're saying, Siege, wait. So you're telling me by that response that there is UFOs out there?
No, if someone knows something and they don't want you to know, and they don't want him to let it out, He ain't talking.
So what happened was back in the 80s, I think it was, is when he first came out about this.
He will commit suicide.
And he came out to the media and he said, if something happens to me, you'll know why and what's happened. So I think by the fact that he's put that out in the public, they're not just going to then shoot him. But they have definitely raided his place, because also they believe he stole a piece of this off-world material or some material that he had. So I think they've always tried to find it. So if they
probably wouldn't shoot him, They'll probably... He'll hang himself. He'll jump off a building.
He'll
be in a car crash.
He'll go Russian style, put him out a window.
Oh, yeah. the Russian out the window.
Yeah. So Siege...
Poison him.
So, Siege, I'm still confused. Is there UFOs in your thinking? Is there any such thing as aliens in your thinking?
I believe we can't be the only ones in this universe.
Okay. I'm confused by the way you're responding.
But I'm saying this. If this guy had information the governments don't want him to let out, he's dead.
But also, the government's killed a lot of people. But also,
1 minute
they
warning.
Might feel like it's more powerful.
That's how long he'd be living for, as they're strangling him.
They might feel like it's more powerful to just discredit him. They're like, they just turn him into a laughing stock. And
okay. Discrediting him takes effort.
Yeah.
Him hanging himself. Not really much effort.
Yeah, but I think, as Ehrman said, if you kill someone after they said, yo, here's information, if I die, you know why.
Yeah.
It doesn't help your cause.
No.
If anything, it makes it worse for you.
Yeah, but it lets the next person know to keep his mouth shut.
the cat's out of the bag at that point. It doesn't matter if they open their mouth.
See, the next person...
Like, and they can always spin it off as this. He said that because he was depressed, clinically depressed. And he committed suicide, and he had things going on in his head. It's a mental issue.
Yeah, yeah.
So they can still spin it if they wanted to.
Yeah,
they could.
Yeah,
but let's not wish this upon him.
Like if I was in the government,
yeah.
Okay.
Air quotes. If I was in the government,
let's not
air
make
quotes.
Me say anything if that I could incriminate you later.
And someone's about to release information that I don't want released.
Air quotes, if I was in the government.
His days are going to be quite limited. He's going to find himself in a car accident.
I have a strong feeling, Siege, that a lot of that you're saying is the reason you're not in the government.
No, see this right now, I only use this as my resume for a job in the government.
CJ, Lucky Siege.
I have no problem with taking someone out.
They're
going
to be looking for a 6'6" guy that's chiseled.
Chiseled.
And has got afro hair.
Nah, long blonde locks.
Like Hercules.